I think most certainly in the last few years, and I think showcasing our foreign policies, talking about it through culturally, you know, talking about not, you know, coercing people to understand what India has to offer. I think over the years, even in terms of ratings and everything everybody's talking about, I'm not so well versed with the economics of it, but when you hear about it, and I travel a lot, and you know, you keep hearing about the growing economy of the country and the way India is inviting everyone to participate in this growth story, in this narrative. I think yes, most certainly, and I think this is, I could think of, you know, the plenary speech of the Honorable Prime Minister here as the beginning, or perhaps the climaxing of you know, the growth story and the soft power that India has to offer. And I think it's a matter of great pride for everyone here at Davos that I'm really glad that I'm here at this point in time when we are perhaps on the cusp of great things for the country.
So talking in terms of inclusive development, you've been working with women and children, you're being awarded the Kestrel Award this year at the World Economic Forum. So do you think that is also a message that the Prime Minister will be looking to put forward in his speech tomorrow at the opening plenary session?
I think the first of all, I'm extremely thankful, grateful for the Kestrel Award, and you know, the work that we've been doing. I mean, it's a little awkward for me because the ideology of Mir Foundation was not to really go public with it, do it very quietly, because I think somewhere down the line, as public as you know, working inclusively with people who have been affected with unfortunate incidents like acid throwing, which I think is extremely cowardly and awful. You know, but somewhere down the line, it's also a very private matter. And yes, I think the Honorable Prime Minister will talk about everything, because these are all parts of changes that are happening in the country.
So talking about inclusive development, do you think that's also going to be a part of the Prime Minister's speech at the opening plenary session?
I think most certainly. I think, as I was saying, every aspect of inclusivity, every aspect that is to be showcased about the country, whether it's the social structure, the changes in that, the economic structure, the foreign policies, the political scenario, I think, and the youngest generation of workforce and the youngest generation of market in the world that India has to offer. I think all of them will be done. And what I find very interesting is I was here last night and watching some Indian channels, and the Honorable Prime Minister Modi ji had some very interesting thing to say. He said, I'm going to Davos not to talk about just the achievements of the country and, you know, to showcase our soft power and send out the India narrative and coerce people to join India and gain from it. But I'm actually going to show off the resilience, the goodness, and the you know, the working culture of 128 crore people, and show that off and tell people that I'm very proud of that. So I think with that attitude, when you come and talk about your country and when you showcase it, I think people realize it's a happy place to be.
Thank you for talking to DD News, sir.
Thank you.